Because I am an idiot, I decided to install Windows 8 on this computer. But don't worry, I won't be keeping it. As you can see, I've installed a bunch of bloatware on it. And how the hell did CCleaner get updated when it's not connected to the internet? It's in airplane mode right now, because I'm a bit worried about all this stuff I installed, even though I only installed one piece of malware, and that's NavaShield, but I removed it from the startup items, so it doesn't try to interrupt the thing I'm about to do. And I also installed this horrible start menu. It's not classic shell. It comes with ads on the start menu. I mean, this is almost worse than the Windows 8 start screen. And various crapware, potentially unwanted programs, stuff like that. Like freaking WinZip malware protector. Like what the hell? Next we'll have WinRAR word processor. I don't know. I wanted to do a video like this for years now. And that's testing the Tron script. It's supposed to restore your computer. Not by reinstalling the operating system, but by removing crapware, bloatware, even malware, and hopefully getting it running better. This is a recent installation, so I purposely went out of my way to install crap programs on it. So it's not as badly infected as a regular computer could be, but since I've been wanting to try Transcript for years, I'm going to try it anyway. It should remove NavaShield, for example, since that's actual malware. It won't defragment the drive, because this is not a mechanical hard drive. It won't remove Adobe Acrobat Reader, that's a normal program. CCleaner, I'm not sure about it, haven't used it in years. And actually Windows Defender is trying to clean something, even though it has a pretty old database. I had it connected to the internet for a while, but it didn't update the virus definitions. So that's odd. What did it detect? Oh, it found something from Tron, Spybot Anti-Beacon. I thought that was a good program, but whatever. Again, these are all definitions. Here we can turn off real-time protection. It's just gonna get in the way. And let's try extracting Tron again. The background is from another piece of bloatware called Bing Wallpaper. And in case you wanna know what this background is, it's this one, placed in Spain. If you want to look it up. Of course, I'm not connected now. So, I've extracted it. I don't remember exactly what you're supposed to do, so let's read the instructions. Notepad, please. Copy tron.bat and resources folder to the desktop. Right-click on tron.bat and run as administrator. Simple enough. I know you can configure various settings, but we'll just use the default ones. So there we have it. Let's go. Okay, I did read the instructions. Type I agree, all caps. Why isn't it skipping defrag? What option do we do to skip defrag? Where does it mention the switches? There it is, SD. So we're just gonna skip the defrag. And let's go. So this is gonna take a while. Don't you think this low battery notification sounds a bit threatening? Charge your phone. Yeah, calm down, I'll do it. I know what happens if I don't. Don't worry about it. Anyway, because that phone's battery is low, I'm using my other phone to record. And Tron is done. It took less than 2 hours. And now let's reboot and see how the computer works. This page opened up. I think it's because of Bing wallpaper being uninstalled. And the crappy IO bit start menu is gone, so we're back to the start screen. Tron is also supposed to install Windows updates, but I didn't have it connected to the internet. It also couldn't update the antivirus and other tools it comes with, so maybe it could have run better. Something from Real Player is missing. That's a shame. The start menu is back, so I guess it just ended the process for it. It didn't actually uninstall it. Well, this isn't malware, and most of this stuff is here because it's not actually malicious. But it's still stuff you wouldn't want to have on your computer. OpenOffice is fine. Nothing wrong with it, even though LibreOffice might be a bit more updated. Restoro is a pretty bad, potentially unwanted program. But that's still here. Would you like to scan your PC? No, I wouldn't. Did it get rid of NavaShield? It actually didn't. And when its special payload activates, it will cause you to lose your unsaved work. And it will block Task Manager and Command Prompt and other programs like that. So let's terminate it before it's too late. The touchpad on this computer is horrible. Still has a Real Player. But you can just uninstall those manually, so not a big deal. The computer was already running pretty fast because it was a new installation. So no speed improvement there. I didn't check how much free space there was before we started, but I think we might have gained a little bit of space. Not exactly sure. So is the Tron script worth it? If you have a badly infected computer and you don't want to back up your files and reinstall Windows, it might be worth a shot, but you should read the instructions thoroughly. For example, it also uninstalls the Windows 8 and 10 Metro apps or modern UI apps, which not all of them are that bad. And it also removed HP Support Assistant, which is actually quite useful for updating drivers on HP computers. So I wouldn't have removed that. If your computer runs fine and you just want to clean up junk files, Tron is not for you. You should use Windows Disk Cleanup. I wouldn't advise using CCleaner either. I heard it's not a really good piece of software these days. Let's take a quick look at the programs list. Yeah, most of these can be uninstalled. But anyway, this was just a test installation of this computer. If I forgot something, I'll add it in the description or in a comment. And even though I cannot provide tech support for this program because I did not create it, I just found it online, you can ask whatever you want in the comments and I'll answer if I can. So that's it. Thank you for watching.